All right. Welcome back to another episode of the Built to Grow podcast. I'm going to be your host for today, Randy Angston, joined by a special friend of ours, an Iron Circle member and a very, very dear friend of Tim and I, Mr. Justin Kegley. How are you doing today, Justin?
Doing great, Randy. Thanks for having me on, man. Super excited to be on the podcast.
We're glad to have you. You've been doing some big things. We know each other on a pretty close level. I know that you're always pushing the limit, both on what's possible within the gym, with yourself as an individual, a man, a father, from all the corners. But one thing I wanted to get to before we dive into today's episode is I want to be the first to congratulate you. On your $500,000 a year. We're going to have, obviously, after the submission, we're going to have one of our chains coming out to you guys. You guys earned it. You've had a really big year in business. You've done some incredible things, both in the studio and with, you know, even outside of it with the real estate, purchasing your facility. So I want to be the first to congratulate you and just tell you how excited we are to see that level of progression and push. You guys are the epitome of what it's like being in the Iron Circle. And it couldn't happen to a better couple, better man. Much love, brother. Congratulations there.
Hey, man, I really appreciate that. Well, first off, you know that you guys have been such a huge help to us, not only in the Iron Circle as we've been for the past couple of years, but we came in to the program through the Business Accelerator. And that was a way for us that we wanted to take it to the next level. Our goal is to make an impact in our community and beyond, but also to create income, because we want to create opportunities for our people, our employees, to have careers, not just to be here for a little bit and then to leave. And so that was really big for us. So we came to you guys and we're like, look, we need some help. And we went through the Business Accelerator program and then into the Iron Circle. And for us, that was a game changer to be able to understand how we can run and own a business rather than running and owning a job. And that was like a major transition for us. It's happened over the past couple of years. It's taken time. But we are super grateful for you guys, and it has made a world of difference in our business and in our lives. So we're grateful for you all.
Well, it's mutual. I mean, obviously, we wouldn't have an opportunity if it wasn't for hungry individuals like you guys. And I mean, I only look forward to the future and what's coming next. I promise you that. So,
absolutely.
But for today, let's dive in. So the reason we have you today is you've got a book launch coming out. Before we get to the details of the book and what that entails, why don't you give us a little background on your training, the area specifically with the youth performance aspect, and kind of what's got you down the path to being here today?
Absolutely. So I am a sports performance coach. We own a facility in Rockford, Illinois called Movement Fitness. And so our goal here was to build a place that we would help people that, you know, we do semi-private personal training, but we also do sports performance. And so I've been training athletes for 15 years. And so it's been a passion of mine to continue to help them to get to the next level. I played college football. It was, you know, really a big passion of mine to continue to push to see how far I could take my abilities. And I wanted to be able to do that for our next generation. And so we built this facility here where we trained people in-house. But as we've continued to grow over years, we just continue to make an impact, especially in female sport performance. That's a big niche for us as we continue to reduce the risk of injury and maximize performance there. So our goal was to, how do we create a place that can really help them differentiate themselves, not only physically, but mentally, to build the physical and mental resilience to allow them to reach their God-given potential and to go beyond what is just the standard and normal in today's society. So our goal is, yeah, we want to train athletes. We want to help them to be bigger, stronger, and faster. And I am a CSCS. I'm a certified functional strength coach. We have so many acronyms behind my name, but you know, that's just over time and learning, because I have a true passion to help people to not only reach their physical, but their mental performance, and to reach the highest level that they possibly can.
Yeah. And it's obviously it's prevalent in the accomplishments of the athletes that have worked with you. I know a number of them have gone on, you know, to pursue college careers and move forward in that progression. But one of the things that I, you know, a good segment into the next book is, you know, this book is actually one of the areas that, you know, as a former youth athlete myself, I don't think anybody's talking about. I mean, mm-hmm. you know, when we talk about nutrition, the whole conversation around nutrition as a high school athlete was, you know, carb loading a spaghetti mm-hmm. dinner, you know, the night before a game or something. Right. And so yeah. getting the team together and just smashing some carbs, but you've taken that one step further. And so why don't we get into, you know, your new book and tell yeah. us a little bit about what you're trying to do there.
So high performance nutrition for high school athletes was written specifically to answer the questions that I was receiving from parents. Okay. So parents are bringing kids in and they know that their kid needs to get faster and stronger and they want to compete at the highest levels. And that is all great. But the second question is, hey, can you talk to them about nutrition? What are we supposed to be eating? Or it's, you know, I've been telling them they should be eating this and they're not doing it. Right. And so there's this battle. And look, I am the parent of two teenagers, soon to be three teenagers. And so I understand the challenges. We have travel sports and there are mm-hmm. practices and games and things that are happening all the time. So life is chaotic and it's busy. So the goal was, is how do we create a guide or a roadmap that would allow both parents and athletes to understand the importance of nutrition and to show them how they can each play a role in their responsibilities? Because we can't have the two pitted against each other. We can't have Absolutely. Athletes that are like, ugh, my mom is just yelling at me and telling me I need to eat, you know, breakfast and I don't really feel like it. And parents on the flip side can't be like, well, I tell them what to eat and they don't do it. And so
yep.
it's a challenge. And then you get to things like tournaments and travel schedules. And you go like, well, I don't even know what they're supposed to eat when we're on the road. And so when we step back, I wanted to start off and go, look, here's the deal. Number one, let's write it to both, because I want to explain not only what is important and what they should be eating, mm-hmm. but why. And when you step back and look at the bigger picture to begin, number one, athletes, if you want to play at the highest level, it's time to start taking some responsibility. If you're a high school athlete, mom and dad aren't making you eat the food. They may yeah. help you prepare it. They may buy the groceries. But guess what? They can't sit with you at lunch and make sure you're eating a healthier lunch and not just Bosco sticks and pizza, right?
They're Come not on. Gonna, those were the not, days. Those were the days.
Those are the days. You know, and to also to share with them to go like, look, it's your responsibility. I also don't expect perfection from an athlete. So we're not living in, you know, this world where it's like, oh, well, you can only eat salads and chicken and stuff like that. Look, we get it that they're a kid. We want to help them to understand what it will take to fuel them to reach their full potential. And so on the flip side of that, though, too, for parents, there's a little bit of this. Look, I understand it's a challenge because they're kids and they're going through hormones and all kinds of stuff, and we battle that. But on the flip side, there's no one that has more impact on your child's nutrition than you. Amen. Because they don't buy the groceries and they don't choose to eat out because it's more convenient on a Tuesday night because practice and we've been running all over the place and I didn't feel like making the food. And so I'm not pointing the finger because I understand, right?
You but, live it.
Right? But you also have to understand, like, hey, what's the priority and what do we want to achieve here?
I love that. And I really love the fact that, like you said, you wrote it to both, because it is a dynamic, right? Mm-hmm. Even with the greatest plan, the greatest execution, at the end of the day, the kids still got to eat the food that's they're deciding to. And, you know, being in a lunchroom, making a decision to eat sometimes food that might not be as appealing or as exciting as that, you know, lunch pizza or, you know, I grew up in Illinois, not far from where you guys are. And yeah. we had Subway, you know, that delivered food every day. And we had, you know, vending machines with every soda possible and, you know, candy bars and snacks and ice cream. And this was a daily availability to us. And to your point, I mean, the level of knowledge and then the application and both are, mm-hmm. are equally as important. So I do love that fact that you kind of, and you're bringing that synergy, you know, between the parent and the athlete. And not pinning them against each other. It's crucial, because the last thing that somebody wants is somebody telling them what to do without understanding why, or, and it can be especially hard for a parent and a child, as we all know. How does give me a little understanding on kind of some of the concepts that the foundation of some of those beliefs, is it in education when it comes to just macronutrition? Mm-hmm. Are we highlighting, protein sources? Like, give me just kind of, bullet points on some of the things that they can expect when they open up that book.
Number one, the first thing that we do is we want to talk about, from a nutrition perspective, is hydration. And so it's really important because hydration impacts, our water impacts every cell in our body. Our body is made up of 60% or more of water, and we have to take care of it. It's the number one thing that decreases performance in athletes. So it's something that we know, but we have to consistently make sure that we are hydrating to stay on track with our goals, to make sure that our practices are that we can compete at the highest level there, so we can ultimately take that into the game. And it's easy. It's one of those things you're like, I didn't drink that. I didn't have enough of that. I didn't have enough of this. Or, right? Then you're like, look, everybody's got one of these now. You got a Stanley, you got a Hydro Flask, you got something like that. There's really no excuse to not. Yeah. But what's easy to do is also easy not to do. And that is the theme of the book and this Jim Rohn quote that ultimately tells us that there's no magic, right? It ultimately comes down to being able to do the things consistently long enough for the compound effect to take effect. So number one is hydration. But the second thing that I want to impress, and we impress upon our athletes here, is a protein first philosophy. And our goal is when you plan your food, think protein first. I'm going to have chicken with dot, dot, dot. I'm going to have, beef with dot, dot, fill in the blank, right? Think that first rather than, well, we're going to have some pasta and we're going to have some, whatever else. Like, think protein first. Think also protein first thing in the morning when you wake up. So that way we ultimately are recovering still from last night's training or practice, but also fueling ourselves for later today, because our body doesn't make or create or store protein. So we have to do that. And lastly, we want to make sure we get protein first thing after our workout, training, or practice. So those things are some simple things. We also have in there, like carbohydrate strategies and things like that. But really, the first thing that I want to impress upon anybody is a protein first strategy, because not only does it help us as athletes, but as we grow, we want to make sure that we maintain that lean muscle tissue over time, because it's going to allow us to live a better life overall. So it's not just an athlete strategy, it's a life philosophy.
And I'm glad you brought that up too, because one of the things that's going through my mind right now is, we train Gen Pop, mom and dads, mm-hmm. of every shape and size every day. And so some of these basic components, they're learning it in their 30s, their 40s, 50s, and beyond sometimes. And making that transition after you've had years of the eating the other way, that's why I think why we see so much resistance around, dietary changes and just even understanding the way that, basic nutrition should be taught or should be looked at. And so with that being said, I think that there is also that education opportunity for the parents. You know what I mean? They're probably going to be making the change, not just for their athlete, but with their own dietary changes, right? It's now getting the whole family involved in a decision to eat better, eat more like a performance athlete. I mean, mm-hmm. obviously, maybe not the same level of calories as somebody who's working five, 6 days a week. But, at the end of the day, the basic components of how to create a meal, how we think about food, how we understand the recovery and the preparation and all of those things come together. You're changing family dynamics, not just, the athlete in.
Absolutely. And if you look at this, you take someone like Dr. Gabrielle Lyon, who just published her book, Forever Strong. And in that, she is speaking specifically to how muscle is the organ of longevity. And the way that we help to build that is through protein and resistance training. And we want to make sure that we get these things ingrained in athletes, because if we help them with these philosophies and these strategies now, ultimately, what's going to happen is it's going to impact them for the rest of their life. You see, I was an athlete through college, but what happened to me is what happens to a lot of athletes, which is we don't understand food And we forget the fact that every day we're practicing and training and you're burning 1,000, 2,000 calories. And then what happens? You stop and all of a sudden, wait a second, yeah. I got this gut going on. I got this, how am I putting it? Why am I putting on weight? I don't understand. And you go like, look, you didn't change your nutritional strategies. And so I don't expect them to become an expert through this book, but what I do want to do is educate them to a point where you go, you know what? As I grow, this is a part of my life. And as I leave sports later on, at some point it's going to end. As you leave sports, it's now time to go like, look, the gym is still a part of my life. So how do I maximize that? And so the goal is to get them to understand that all of this has an impact on each other, nutrition and training and how we live our lives. And so it's not just about what you're doing as an athlete, but it also provides long-term strategies that are now proven and are now shown to be better and more efficient than the traditional food pyramid that we were fed when we were younger.
Amen to that. Yeah, amen. I mean, I know we're in alignment with those beliefs. And obviously, like you said, you know, science is showing that. Tim and I just referenced Gabriel Lyon with the episode that we had Chris Poirier on. You know, massive attention to not just the athletic side of things, but how it does translate to literally longevity and the quality of life that you're going to have for the rest of it. And so, you know, kudos to you, because ultimately what you're doing is you're changing lives for the long haul, you know, and having the ability to address it at such a young age. You know, we live in a society right now where we have astronomical obesity rates. I mean, even with young children, you know, pre-diabetic, you know, kids at 7 years old, 8 years old that are they're destined for a life of hardship simply because of a lack of understanding and application when it comes to the food we're putting in our mouth. And so, and even with that being said, it goes so much further than just maybe the physical components of it, the disease prevention, all of that, man. And so really, I just want to give you a hats off, you know, take my hat off to you and give you props for making a decision to address not only just a need for those athletes, but attacking a problem that's going to have ripple effects through that family and through the longevity of everybody that's involved.
Well, I appreciate that. And, you know, as we, you know, wrap this up, I think of what Andy Frisella talks about, personal excellence is the ultimate rebellion. And when you look at where you're at, what we do with our bodies, you know, how we think, what we eat, what we fuel ourselves, how we train, how we take care of ourselves is ultimately up to us. So Amen. When we can control the controllables, that is the stuff that we can be in control of. And when I look at athletes, if you're serious about going to the next level, then you're going to have to take responsibility for yourself. You're going to have to stand out. And you talked about it earlier, you know, being in the lunchroom, your friends are eating this and, you know, they're drinking, you know, Coke and soda and they're doing different stuff. And you're like, well, I could do that or not. Well, that's going to apply to your whole life. You can either go along to get along or you can stand out. And if you want to stand out, you're going to have to start taking responsibility for yourself. And so I want to help, you know, provide some strategies for that. And so that's a big part of it. And so you're responsible for your own life. And there's no reason that anyone should ever outwork you or make you feel like you're not giving your best.
I love it. I love it, man. Well, as this podcast is released, your book just released this week.
Yep.
What's the easiest way for them to, we'll put in the show notes, but what's the easiest way for them to find that?
Yeah. Easiest way to get is through Amazon. So we'll share the link, in the podcast bio, obviously, but that's the easiest and quickest way to get the book, High Performance Nutrition for High School Athletes.
Perfect, brother. Well, with that, we'll wrap things up. I appreciate it again. Obviously, like I said, there's nobody on the team I'd like to see as much as you. I know that we're just going to continue doing incredible things because of the choices and the disciplines that you've created, and you're going to continue to pour that forward. So hats off. I commend you on this book, and I look forward to reading the next as, you know, your gears start turning and you start to figure out who it is you're going to serve next.
Absolutely. Well, I appreciate your time, Randy. Thanks. I appreciate you and Tim. And obviously our whole team on the Iron Circle and everybody for their support in this. And so grateful for you guys. Thanks so much.
Absolutely. Well, with that being said, appreciate you guys joining us for another episode of the Built to Grow podcast. We'll see you on the next show.
All right. And thank you for listening to that episode of the Built to Grow podcast, where we help gym owners win. Now, do you want to connect with me and other gym owners online? All you need to do is join our private Facebook group, Business Talk with Fitness Professionals. Just head on over to Facebook and type in Business Talk with Fitness Professionals. And when you do, we're going to give you our 10 marketing strategies seven-figure gym owners use to win. I look forward to seeing you in the next episode. Until then, keep building something great.